2019 AP Calculus ABFRQ problem 5, yeah? And yes, I've taken the time to draw you a nice little visual. Okay, and yeah, so in A, we have to figure out the area of R, and that's fairly straightforward. Since x goes from 0 to 2, we go from 0 to 2, and then the top function minus the bottom function, and then dx, we're adding up along x, right? Okay, cool. We're adding up like these heights along x. That's why it's top function minus bottom function, right? Now, it's important to determine which function is on top, and here's easy way to do it, which is for x equals 0, if I plug in x equals 0 here, I get 6 minus 2, which is 4. And so that's the y-intercept for this function, and therefore I know that the quadratic is on top. I could also see that the quadratic is facing down, right? So there are other ways, but yeah, the top function is the quadratic, so we go, this is, I need the space, so this is 0 to 2, and then the top function is 6 minus 2 times x minus 1 squared, and then minus, the bottom function is g of x, right? The cosine function that's transformed. And so like subtracting it is the same as changing the signs there. So I'll go plus 2 and then minus 3 cosine of pi over 2x. And then of course dx, right? Okay, cool. Now, does anything simplify? I suppose these guys combine to an 8, right? So I can write an 8 here. I hate 6. Okay, but otherwise, slide. Otherwise, yeah, like, okay, and so this is going to be 8x and then minus 2 times x minus 1 cubed over 3. Yes, it seems casual that I have a composition of functions. I could view it that way if I want, and I just did the power rule as if I'm just doing like u squared. Antiderivative, and I did that because if I let u equal x minus 1, du is just dx. So yeah, that's why. But don't be this casual and think that you could just do this all the time, right? Okay, now the antiderivative of cosine is sine, because the derivative of sine is cosine. So we have negative 3 times sine of pi over 2x. But not quite, right? Because if we take the derivative of this, we're going to get 3 times cosine. Well, there's that minus, and that's, so I've retained that. But yeah, the derivative of this after the minus sign is 3 cosine pi over 2x times pi over 2. But there is no pi over 2 here, right? So to make up for it, I need to multiply this by 2 over pi, which is like dividing by pi over 2. Right? Okay, and then, of course, I need to evaluate this from 0 to 2. Which means I plug in 2, and then I plug in 0 and take the difference. Okay, I hope 0 makes things nice. Yes, in this part at least. Right? Okay, because I really don't want to do the arithmetic, but I'll do it. You might not feel my videos complete unless I do. So I have 16 minus 2 times. If I plug in 2 here, I get 2 minus 1, so that's 1. 1 cubed is 1, so it's just 2 thirds, minus 2 thirds. And if I plug in 2 in here, I get minus 3 times sine of pi over 2 times 2, right? So that's sine of pi. But sine of pi is 0, remember. Sine is the one that starts at 0 and comes down, so it's 0. Good. Thank the Lord Jesus Christ. That's gone. Okay, and then now we plug in 0, minus. When I plug in 0, that's nil, right? And then I have, when I plug in 0 in here, I get, well, this minus is from the evaluation theorem. So I have minus 2 over 3, and then plug in 0 here gets us negative 1 cubed, which is negative 1. So that turns this into a plus. Right, okay, that's nice. And then when I plug in 0 in here, I get minus 3 times sine of 0, and sine of 0 is 0. Yes, I have this constant multiplying it also. So, like, it's 6 over pi here, but remember, I don't like 6. But yeah, since sine of 0 is 0, this whole thing is annihilated, right? So, like, yeah, this is it. Okay, now, I've got minus 2 thirds plus 2 thirds. So that's... No, I don't have that. I have minus 2 thirds minus 2 thirds. And so that's minus 4 thirds, right? Okay. And so I could get rid of this and be like, all right, this is it. Now, if I get common denominators, that's 48 thirds minus 4 thirds. So 48 minus 4 over 3. 44 over 3? Yeah, I believe so. Okay, so that's it for A. All right. So B is, we're told that we have cross sections perpendicular to the x-axis, and their area is this, the area of the cross section. So normally, like, we have triangular cross sections and whatnot, and we don't know what this cross section looks like. This is like coming out of the page what I drew, but whatever it is, it's perpendicular to the x-axis, right? This cross sectional area, this is supposed to be coming out of the page, as I said. It's perpendicular to the x-axis, so we're adding it along x, and therefore our integral has to have a dx here. But otherwise, we're adding up these areas that are defined by that area function a of x. So that's 1 over x plus 3 dx. And of course, going from 0 to 2. And so the antiderivative of this is the natural log of x plus 3. And we evaluate this from 0 to 2. So if we plug in 2, we get the natural log of 5. If we plug in 0, we get the natural, so minus the evaluation theorem, right? And we plug in 0, we get the natural log of 3. And I have videos on logs, lots of them, but yeah, 5 over 3. Yeah? Okay, cool. So that's it for B, and on to C. Okay, C. Okay, and so for part C, the question is this. We have a horizontal line y equals 6, so that's like here, right? And y equals 6. And we are rotating this region R about that line and asked to find the volume of that solid. Now, here's what that rotation would look like. So, like, I would have like a small circle like that, right? And then that's little r, so this here is little r, and then big R would be like a big circle like that out of the page, right? Okay, and so as you can see, what I formed is a washer, and that washer is supposed to be perpendicular to the x-axis, and so then we're adding up these washers to create the solid, right? And so we see that one of the washers has area pi big R squared minus pi little r squared. And so we can write that as pi times big R squared minus little r squared. And since we're adding up the washers along x, we have to have a dx here, right? So we go dx. Okay, now what is big R? Big R is this y value minus this y value. And so big R is equal to 6 minus the cosine function, which is negative 2 plus 3 cosine of pi over 2x, right? And little r, on the other hand, is 6 minus the quadratic. So it's going to be 6 minus, what was the quadratic? Was it like 6 minus 2 times x minus 1 squared? I believe so. So there you go, and substitute, and you actually don't have to do this, and we're going from 0 to 2, but yeah. Just says find an expression, so that's that. Keep watching. Take care.